Hello and welcome to our presentation. My name is Andrea Papenmeier and I will present our work on how humans perceive different types of classification mistakes. The accuracy of a machine learning system influences how humans see a system, for example, whether they trust and rely on a system. We usually calculate the accuracy by comparing system predictions with the ground truth. You can see some example data here, short utterances that are labeled with product categories. In this case, it's laptops and jackets. Seems like an easy task, right? And you might already guess that a system predicts all data points correctly. So we calculate an accuracy of 100%. And users also think the predictions are right because they are obviously all correct. So your system has a perceived accuracy of 100% as well. But how about this data here? What do you think the accuracy will be? It's quite hard to say, isn't it? Maybe compared to the ground truth, we have an accuracy of 33%, but your users are not sure about those mistakes. Good computer brand, that also makes sense, right? But it could also be your jacket brand, so it's difficult to say. So maybe overall, your users will say it's around 80% correct. And this illustrates the problem quite well. Datasets are often annotated by people, and if you have data like this one here, the ground truth might not be 100% reliable. Data can be ambiguous, which leads to disagreement between annotators, but also disagreement between end users and the predictions, or the end users and the ground truth. And the ambiguity is data point specific. So you might have a data point that is very clear and easy to label for a human, and in the same data set, another data point might be difficult and ambiguous. So we wanted to dive deeper into the effects of data ambiguity on end users, and set out to investigate how prediction mistakes at different levels of ambiguity affect the perceived accuracy. Of course, to explore ambiguity and prediction mistakes, we first need a suitable data set. We decided for a data set with descriptions of laptops and jackets, and for those sentences, we collected information about the ambiguity as perceived by users. So we ended up with data points for which we had not only the ground truth, but also information about the ambiguity. We did that with a crowdsourcing experiment. This is described in more detail in the paper. The important part here is that we ended up with three groups of sentences with low, medium, and high ambiguity. Sentences that are easy to classify for humans, difficult to classify for humans, and sentences that are impossible to classify for humans. From the three sentence groups, we constructed two smaller data sets for our experiments, a mixed data set with 10 sentences from each group, and also an easy data set with 30 sentences only from the easy group. Then we simulated different classifiers that make mistakes on different sentence types. Our first fictive classifier in condition A made 8 prediction mistakes on easy sentences. In B, we have 8 mistakes on difficult sentences. And in C, the mistakes are made on impossible sentences. In all three conditions, we see the same number of prediction mistakes, meaning that the calculated accuracy is the same in all three conditions, which is 73%. As a control condition, we also made a classifier with 100% calculated accuracy and applied this classifier to both data sets, so the one with the mixed sentences and the one with only easy sentences. As for the study procedure, we recruited over 200 participants, such that we have 45 participants in each condition. We confronted each participant with 30 predictions, you can see a screenshot here, and in the end we asked them how many predictions were correct in total, which then represents their perceived accuracy. So let's have a look at the results. As expected, we see a rather low perceived accuracy in condition A, slightly higher perceived accuracy for condition B, and the highest score in condition C. Those differences were significant, which means that the type of prediction mistake had a significant influence on how participants perceive the performance, even though all three systems have the same performance on paper. If we compare those numbers with the calculated accuracy, which was 73% in all three conditions, we find that in A, our calculated accuracy is significantly higher than the perceived accuracy, and in C, the calculated score is significantly lower than what the participants perceived. A similar observation can be made with other performance measures, like precision or recall or the F1 score, for example. none of them accurately represents the perceived accuracy of our participants, which makes sense because those traditional measures treat all prediction mistakes equally, but this is apparently not how humans perceive prediction mistakes. We also asked our participants to give us some details about their decision, and they told us that it was sometimes difficult to say whether the prediction is correct, and this promoted interesting decision strategies. First, some participants told us that they tended to agree with the prediction whenever they were in doubt. So participants were drawn to agree with what they see unless it seems implausible. And secondly, some participants mentioned that they did not see the task as a binary classification because sometimes both classes are equally plausible, or both are plausible but one is just a little more likely than the other. Besides looking at different prediction mistakes, we also looked at classifiers that made no mistakes to see what percentage of the perceived accuracy is due to people disagreeing with the ground truth and not necessarily with a classifier. We did that for both datasets, so the one with mixed sentences and the one with only easy sentences, and we see a significant difference between those two conditions. So we conclude that some effect is due to some characteristic of the dataset. The presence of impossible or difficult sentences reduce the perceived accuracy. That means that we can build the best classifiers and systems, but that still does not mean that our users will accept the predictions. So in conclusion, we derive from our findings that we need to think about new metrics to better estimate how a machine learning system will be perceived by end users. We could, for example, think about adding a cost to each data point that reflects the level of ambiguity. And a new metric should also account for dataset composition independent of the amount of mistakes, because we saw in our control conditions, not only mistakes reduce the perceived accuracy, the presence of ambiguous data points also reduces the perceived accuracy. And with those ideas, I close our presentation for now. Thanks for listening.